this tutorial, you're going to learn how to use C++ to input and output different types of data, including strings. You can see in a sample run of this program, I can input the user's name, their age, and their GPA. So that deals with a string, an integer value, as well as a double data type. Let's take a look at how to write the code to work with something like this. We start off with the basic program. Now, the big thing to keep in mind in C++, if I'm working with strings, I have to provide the preprocessor directive to string, or else my program won't know how to work with the CN object on a string data type. The next step is going to be to declare the variables I want to work with, age, name, and GPA. I've got my variables declared here. For the user's name, I'm using a string data type, for their age, an integer, and for their GPA, a double data type. Now I'm ready to collect the user input. In the next sequence of instructions, I'm prompting the user for their name, and then saving that data to my string name variable, prompting the user for their age and saving that data to the age variable, and then finally their GPA and saving that data to the variable I named GPA. Notice that each are a different data type. Now I'm ready to add some instructions that will print out the data in sentence form. In these next couple of sentences, I just print out the data in sentence form, so I'm still using cout, referencing the name variable, and then concatenating together the sentence with the use of strings. So if you take a look, again, the sentence is being printed out, but it's being dynamically built based upon what the user input. The big thing to remember here is to make sure to include a reference to your string object. If I didn't have that there, then my CNs would have a real problem, and also my cout would have a real problem working with that string data. And frankly, if I try and compile this, it's going to have some errors. However, if I make sure to include that preprocessor directive to string, all of those red, ugly, squiggly lines disappear, and I know I have an error-free program. So give it a practice run. Enter in a name. An age, and now a GPA, and it works just fine. In this tutorial, you learned how to work with different data types in a very simple program, but the thing to focus in on is working with that string data and the string preprocessor directive.